Good morning. Welcome to day 10. Again, very sunny outside, beautiful day. Take a few minutes to get ready, put your mat ready. If you have blocks, put them near you. If you have a strap, it can always come in handy. I've been thinking about a theme for today and I'm not so sure actually. Maybe I'm a bit sore in my upper back, so maybe we'll do some shoulder opening, back opening, and just see where we end up. I wanted to remind you all that if you at any point have suggestions or ideas or wishes for the practice, you're more than welcome to comment or send me a message. It's super nice to hear from you all. It really makes my day when I hear how people are doing. And so yeah, the reason I'm doing this, besides giving myself a reason to get out of bed in the morning and practice, is also just to share and to see what happens if I open up my living room, our living room, in this virtual kind of way. So you're more than welcome to let me know if there's anything specific you would like to do in the upcoming days, or a theme you would like to explore, something you're missing, or something you're just curious about. All right, let's get started. Come to your mat.
And music on?
Yes, please. We will get ourselves situated. Organizing the technicalities. So just come to your mat. Come to a child's pose. And just relax there. Take some deep breaths. Good morning to those of you who are just joining. Go and sit on your mat in a child's pose. You can have your hands either out in front of you or to the side of your body, depending on what feels good to you right now. Take a few deep breaths into your belly. Feel your lower body expand as you breathe in. And sink down as you breathe out. Middle back into the back of your ribs. You can let it out with a your shoulders.
in-breath. Again, breathe in as deep, 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 deep as you can. And then hold it at the top. And take an extra little sip of air. And then even one more. One last one. And then let it go. Breathing out all the way, all the way. Emptying your lungs. Feeling the chest. Taking in an extra sip. One more. One last one. And hold. And then letting it go out all the way. Relaxing your neck. Pushing all the air out, out, out. And then letting your breath normalize. Breathing in and out, relaxed. Feeling your back expanding. Using your hands to roll your back up. Sitting on your knees. Opening your chest to the ceiling. Breathing in. And rounding down slightly with the head while you breathe out. Very gentle, curling up through the back. Breathing in and rounding down, breathing out. A few more times in your own timing. Starting to roll your shoulders. As you roll up, the shoulders come up. As you roll down, rolling the shoulders down. Rolling up, shoulders come front and up. Rolling down, shoulders come back and down. Reverse the direction, rolling up, your shoulders come back and up, rolling down, your shoulders come front and down. A few times waving through the back. To center, rolling up, dropping your head to the right side, grabbing with your right hand over your left ear, gentle stretch. And moving that right hand to the back of your head and turning the head down, so down towards your armpit, rolling there a few times, moving the head a bit side to side, deep stretch on the left side of your neck, and let it go, lift your head. Grab your head with the left hand over the right ear. dropping the head towards the left, stretching your right side of your neck, and then moving the hand to the back of your head, turning your head towards the left and down into your armpit. Gentle movement there, side to side of the head. Keep breathing. And then rolling your head to the front, grabbing with both hands, letting the weight of the elbows drop. No pulling. Just drop your head down very gently. Gently rolling it side to side, stretching the back of your neck, let it go, put your hands behind your hips, lift your chest to the ceiling, pull your shoulder blades back, let your head drop. Stretch the front of your throat. Coming back up. Taking your right arm in front of your chest. Pulling it close towards you with the left. Stretching out the outer right shoulder. Top of the arm. Keep moving. Pull a little bit closer and let it go a bit. Move your arm, wiggle. Let it go, change sides. Pulling your left arm across your chest with the right. Seeing what happens when you pull the shoulder more down. Maybe it increases the stretch. Let go, lift your right arm over your head. Grab the right elbow with the left hand and pull it towards the left. Opening up your right shoulder and even the top of your right rib cage. And then rolling your head back and forth, side to side, that means against your shoulder. Let it go. Change sides. Lift your left elbow over your head, grab it with the right hand, and pull it over towards the right. And then rolling your head side to side. Take your right hand behind your back with the palm facing the back wall, grabbing your right elbow with your left hand and pulling it gently to the front. If you can't reach your elbow, you can start on the top, so walking your left hand from the shoulder down towards your right elbow. Gently pulling your elbow to the front. Moving few times up and down. And try to take the weight of your right arm in your left hand. So don't use any of the muscles around your right shoulder blade. But let the left hand do all the work. Circling a few times. Change sides, positioning the left back of your hand on the left back of your head, back, your palm facing outward, grabbing your left elbow with the right hand, pulling it very gently forward. Shoulders. Then come to all fours. Spreading your fingers. Your wrists are below your shoulders. Then lift up the palm of the hand a few times. So leaving fingers on the floor, your thumbs may come up as you do this. Stretching the back of the fingers, strengthening the wrists. Let that go, tuck your toes in. Just off the floor, and then start to circle the torso, circling the wrists, circling the hips, the knees, the toe joints, reverse directions. Back to the center, gently drop your knees down, lift your hands, flip the palms, palms facing up, wrists to the front, fingers pointing towards you, stretching out at the front of the wrists, gently leaning back to increase the stretch. Stay relaxed in your shoulder blades. Turn your hands with the palms down, fingers towards you, wrists to the front, and same thing, stretching out the wrists, moving gently back and forth a few times. Keep the back of your neck relaxed, keep your shoulder blades as soft as you can. If you want to increase the stretch, you can lift your knees slightly off the floor. And then drop the knees down, start to bend the elbows into your chest, slowly peeling the hands off. Thank you. back to all fours. And with your toes tucked under, again we're gonna lift the knees slightly off, and then we're gonna cat cow with the knees off the floor. So breathing in, hollowing your back out, looking up at the ceiling, breathing out, rounding your back, keeping your knees in the same place, floating above the floor. Do this 5 times in your own timing. And if it's too much for you this early, just drop the knees back down to the floor. Times dropping the knees down, uncurl the toes, push back into a child's pose. Walk your fingers as far forward as you can. Keep your elbows off the floor and drop your head. Drop your elbows down. Shift the weight forward onto the elbows. Your hands, lower arms are parallel to the outsides of your mat. Tuck your toes under and come into a dolphin pose. Pushing into your elbows, letting your head drop. Walking through the feet a few times. Then lifting the right foot just off the floor, pointing, flexing the foot, putting it back down. Same on the other side. Just gently figuring out what we need to do with the weight. Lifting the left foot, pointing, flexing, putting it back down. One more time, right side. Pointing, flexing, back down. Left side, pointing. Flexing, putting it back down. Now come up onto the balls of both feet and shift the weight back a few times. Coming to the front. As you shift back, your back straightens out. Shifting to the front, pelvis coming in. Shifting back, pelvis sticking up. Two more times. Then looking forward, dropping the knees down, coming back into a child's pose, and the toes stay tucked under this time. Lifting the elbows off the floor. Now lift the wrists, keep the fingertips on the floor. And drop your head. looking up at your hands, releasing the hands down, walking them slightly towards you. Untuck your toes. So you're back in all fours. Reaching the right arm up to the ceiling. And then sticking it through your left. Placing your right side of your head on the mat, pushing down through the left hand to twist your back open. Keeping the hips even. And then roll your face slightly back down. Right cheek is on the mat, left hand starts to crawl forward and back over your head. Towards the right corner, opening the left shoulder here. Then gently walk the hand back. Now, shift your knees backwards, so shimmy your knees backwards. Keeping the right arm underneath you, come to lying on your belly. Stretching the front of the right shoulder. And if you want to increase this stretch, roll your weight over to the left hip, release your right leg, walk your knee up. And then you can use that right knee to push more down if you want to have a bigger stretch. Come out of it, join your two legs together. Push from your left hand. Come into a small cobra. Pull your sternum through the ribs. And rolling down, using the hands to push yourself up and come into all fours again. Now lift your left arm up to the ceiling. Bend down, stick it through underneath your right hand. Push from that right hand to twist your back open towards the ceiling. Keeping your hips even. And release the push a little bit. Your left cheek comes to the mat, right hand curls forward, and then over the top of your head towards the left corner. Use that right hand to push down into the floor to increase the stretch under your right armpit. Then slowly walk the hand back. And then start to walk the knees back one by one until you're lying on your belly. A And if this is enough of a stretch, stay here. If you'd like to increase, move the weight over to the right side into your right hip. Walk your left foot slowly out and bend your left knee so it comes to the side. Keep the back of your neck relaxed. Walk your left foot back down, join your legs together. Put your right hand next to your face and push up from it to come back into the small cobra. Elbows below your shoulders. Hands are spread out so you can pull through the hands to pull your sternum through the rib cage forward and up. Lift your face. And then keeping the hands there, straighten your knees, push through the hands. And if you want to increase this, just walk your hands closer to you. Keeping the shoulder blades down, keeping the shoulders moving away from the ears. And then come back into a child's pose. Open your knees as wide as the mat. Put your head on the floor. Roll your head side to side a few times. Let that movement arrive in the hips as well. So your whole torso is swaying side to side. Then slowly lift your head up. You're leaning on your elbows, side to side, side to side. Walking your elbows very, very slowly back towards your torso. Very small steps. And taking the weight into the hands. Keep swaying side to side, side to side. And let it go. Move your knees to the middle. Tuck your toes under. Straighten your legs. Hang over. Slightly bent. Your opposite elbows. Start to also sway side from side, side to side here, bending your knees one by one. Very gently rocking. Slowly start to round the back up, enjoying the whole way up. head hangs down, hips are coming up. Let go of the hands, but keep going with the knees. Figure of eight. Let your arms open a bit to the side. To the front of your mat. Taking a deep breath in, lifting your arms overhead. And swan diving down. Come halfway up. And rolling down. Let's do that five times. Breathing in, coming halfway up. Rolling down. Now stepping or jumping back into to a stillness in the middle. Putting your knees down on the floor. Let's do five push-ups. Of course, you're also welcome to do these with your knees off the floor. Upward facing dog and into downward facing dog. Walk your feet out, shifting your hips side to side, pushing down through all of the fingertips. Your weight is spread out through the hands by spreading the fingers. To a stillness, dropping your head, sticking your sit bones up to the ceiling. Lifting your right foot slightly off the floor, only a little bit, pointing the right foot, pulling the knee into the chest five times, moving back to that low place with your foot and into the chest. Next time, keeping your knee there, hovering for a moment, then articulating through the foot, put the foot down between your hands, leaning. circulating through your left foot. Out-breath, sinking your hips lower down. If this is enough, stay here. If you like, clasp your hands above your head. Pull your ribcage up and bend back. Keeping the hips moving down. To your chest, and then twisting over to the right side, placing your left elbow on the outside of your right knee, pushing down with your right hand, twisting the back, your right foot to untwist. Open the hands, place them next to your foot. Step into plank position. Chaturanga down. Upward dog. Downward facing dog. Five breaths. Slightly off the floor, point the foot, pull it into your chest and move the weight forward over the hands, and move back, five times, foot stays low, sinking your hips down as you breathe out. stay there, or if you want to go into the back end, clasp your hands, release the pointed fingers, pull your ribcage up to move up and over to the back, pulling your shoulders out while your hips keep moving forward and down. Release the hands, let them come to the chest into prayer. Then breathing in, lifting the ribcage and out, twisting over to the left side. Right elbow on the outside of your left knee, pushing down from the left hand. Either stay here or tuck your right toes under and straighten the right leg. Pushing down more into that left hand. Tilting your pelvis to the ceiling, pushing down through all your fingertips, letting your neck hang. Then look up at your hands and step or jump back. Right away, lifting the right foot, this time to 90 degrees with the hip straight, knee facing down, foot flexed. Point the foot and come up onto the ball of your left foot and put it back down 5 times. Your leg stays parallel. Bend the knee and pull it in towards the outside of your right shoulder. Let's do 3 of these. place your right hand on the inside of your right foot. Continuing to push your hips down. Take your left arm overhead. If you're feeling very strong, take your right arm off the floor. Down, dropping the hand down, stepping your foot back to the plank, chaturanga down, up dog, downward facing dog. Lifting the left leg with the foot parallel, flexed, hips stay even. Next one, hover there with your knee outside for a moment, and then pull the knee to the center, put your foot between your hands, lift into warrior one, opening into warrior two, and then five times straightening the front leg, lifting the arms. Dropping your left hand on the inside of your left foot, lifting your right arm up. Overhead. And then lifting the left arm up. Twisting down. Position your hands next to your foot, roll your right foot in, step your left foot back into plank, chaturanga down, up, and I realize I forgot something, lifting the left leg back up. Coming onto the ball of the right foot five times. Just do that so that we're even. Positioning the foot back down. Looking up at your hands, stepping or jumping back. Halfway up. knees to roll up. One deep breath at the top.
Breathing in. Lifting the arms overhead. And out, swung back and forward. Dog, always with the option of an extra push-up if you want.
Lift the right foot up, point the toe, open the hip, bend the knee and let the foot fall over. Towards the floor, taking the weight into the left hand, lifting your right hand up and opening your chest to the ceiling. Come back the same way you came in. Position your hand next to your left hand. And then coming into a plank with his legs still lifted. Pulling your knee into your chest. Slipping your foot between your legs. Flowing into warrior one. Into warrior two. Straighten your front leg. Flip your palm. Drop your left arm down and move your right arm up and over to the back. Windmilling your arms back down. Now twisting your whole upper body and lifting your left heel off the floor. So you're on the ball of your left foot, and we're going to come down with a straight back, moving the arms down towards the floor, or placing them on your shin. Hips are straight, and back is long. Neck is long. And then staying on the ball of your left foot, leaning on your left fingertips or on a block, open the right arm up to the ceiling. Side wall. lift your left leg up. First parallel, point the foot and open the hip. Keep your shoulders pushing evenly into the floor. Drop your foot, bend the knee. And then start to move your foot towards the floor, shifting the weight into the right hand. Opening your chest up to the ceiling. Coming back the same way you came in. Putting your left hand next to the right. Lifting the left leg up. Then keeping it lifted. Come into plank, so reaching with your head first. Then pull your knee into your chest. Slowly drop the foot down. Come into warrior one. Flowing straight into warrior two. Straightening your front leg. Bending back. Placing your right hand on the back of your right leg. Windmilling your arms and turning your arms to the front, lifting your right toe up. You're coming to a parallel position with the hips, and then with a straight back, going over to the front, staying on the ball of your right foot. And you can put your hands on your shin at first. Keeping your back long. And then if you can, placing the fingertips on the floor or using a block here. And then opening your left hand to the side, twisting. Slightly bent leg, already straighten your back. So it's almost like you're arching your lower back, feeling as if you're arching. Walking the fingertips forward, moving the weight over the left foot, straightening the leg, lifting the right foot up. And let's flex the right foot so we feel a really parallel position here. The legs. And then open the hip, the right hip up to the ceiling. Move your right arm up towards the ceiling. Open your chest to the side. And find balance here. And if you're very stable, you can start to turn your head to the right side. So come out of it, look down, bend your left knee, bring down your left, your right hand, step back into a lunge. Step your left foot back, chaturanga down, upward facing dog, downward facing dog. then bend your knees, bring them down to the mat. Walk your hands forward. Put your chin on the mat. Open up your shoulders here. So your face is looking at the front. Push into the elbows to come up. And then lie down on your front. Turn your head to the right. Put your toes together, heels flap open. Forehead on the floor, close your heels, straighten through the legs, clasp your hands behind your back, the direction of your hands is first to go towards your heels, so pulling your hands towards your heels, pulling your chest off the floor, and then pulling up the hands a little bit. The ceiling. Your knees are straight, shoulder blades together. Open your face up. Take one more deep breath in and go slightly higher. And then slowly come down, unclasp the hands. Right ear on the mat, looking to the left. Toes together, heels fall open. Your forehead on the mat. Again, clasp your hands behind your back, this time with the other thumb on top. Heels come together, knees are straight. Pulling your hands down towards your heels to pull your back to come up. And then once you're up, you can increase the stretch on the shoulders by slightly lifting up your wrists. Clasp your hands, face to turn to the right, left cheek on the floor. Now move your arms to the side. Place your chin on the floor. In-breath, you're going to move arms and legs up at the same time. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Placing everything down, turning your head to the left. sides. And try and keep your knees as parallel as you can. And then to start this move, the movement starts from the feet moving to the back. So your feet are kicking into your hands. And that's what pulls your back off the floor. And then the top of your thighs move up. You roll onto the front of your belly. Moving the face up, kicking the knees further up, keeping the parallel. 5, 4, 3, come up higher, 2, 1. Let it go. Release the legs, turn the head to the right. Down on the floor again, and this time we're going to grab the ankles from the inside. So turning your palms, twisting them, facing out. Now you can open your knees a little bit. Grab the insides of the ankles. And same principle. The movement starts because your feet kick into your hands. That's what lifts your back up. Shoulders soft, shoulder blades together, kicking up, lifting your face to the ceiling. 5, kick up more. 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly coming down. Head turns to the left. Stretching out the bottom of the feet for a moment. Then lifting your pelvis up, coming to stand on top of your knees. Put your hands in your lower back. Lift the ribcage up and move backwards over a ball. Push your hips forward, and then reaching to the heels. Opening your chest. And gently come out. Untuck your toes, open your knees a little bit, not quite as wide as the mat, just slightly wider than your feet. Same thing, starting with your hands on your lower back, lifting your chest up to drop your head back and lean backwards. Then gently reaching your hands to your knee, to your heels. pushing your hips forward. Open the chest. And slowly come out. Come down into a child's pose. Let's have your lower back. Using your hands to roll up. Come to a seated position with your legs long in front of you. Straighten the arms in front of you. And then tuck your pelvis under. Slowly, slowly, slowly round the back. Rounding all the way down. Resist the urge to use momentum, so the moment that you feel you want to speed up, slow it down even more. Start to roll your back down all the way. Hands come overhead. Same way back. Starting from tucking your chin towards your chest. Your back is round. And feel that moment where you want to use a bit of extra force to pull yourself up and move through that moment as slowly as you can. Keeping the back round until you reach the sit bones. Then unrolling the pelvis, rolling up the back. Your pelvis under really slowly, rounding down, keep breathing, slow down the moment where you want to use momentum, the moment right before your lower back hits the floor. Rolling your back all the way down, lifting your arms overhead. Take a breath in. And come down, come back up, exactly the same way you came down. Rounding the back, shoulders. Keeping your back round until you reach the sitting bones. And then rolling your pelvis. And then your middle back, upper back, shoulders, straight. and going back with a straight back as far as you can until you cannot hold it anymore, and then you can tuck your pelvis under. So leaning back with a straight back, slowly pulling in your lower abs, pulling in all your abs really. And when you reach a point where you feel you can no longer stay going down straight, then you tuck first the pelvis, roll your back, make it fully round, and roll down. Same exact way, coming back, rolling, curling your head up, lifting your chin towards the chest, and then untucking the pelvis to straighten out your back. Lifting your back, come to the front just for a moment, shake it out. We'll do that one more time. If you want, you can try to go all the way down with a straight back if you can, and if not, just roll your pelvis the moment you can't hold it anymore. Once you're down, stepping your feet so your knees are up, pulling your head from the side, doing a few simple crunches. Let's say we do 10, 9, 8. To the left hip. Let's do 5. This is 4. 5. Change sides. 1. Again. 5. 4. Five on the other side, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Stretching out your legs and arms. Arching your lower back. Relax your hands, reach up to towards your ankles. Pull your knees in towards your shoulders. And pull your ankles down towards the floor. Very round back. Relaxing the shoulders. And sway it side to side. Reaches the floor, bend your knees, keep holding on to the sides of your feet. Happy baby stretch. Up and down a few times to get back to sitting. If you want to test your strength, your core, your balance here, release the hands. Knee. hands to pull on the foot. Keep straightening out the lower back. Now open your right knee a little bit. So walk your left foot forward more. Place your left elbow on the inside of your left knee. Reach your right arm up. And then over. Stay here, or you can grab the top of the foot. This time a bigger distance between both knees, so you can use your left hand to crawl through if you can't reach the foot. Stretch, so you're pulling on your foot, you're straightening out your lower back, your face is on top of your right knee, and then put your left hand on top of your right foot, sneak your right hand through, grab your left knee with the right hand, pull your shoulder, your right shoulder in front of your right knee, and open up your chest towards the ceiling. Gently come out, push from your hands, then opening the left hip by walking your right foot a little bit more forward, placing the right elbow in front of the right knee, opening the left hand to the ceiling, and then moving the hand overhead. Welcome to stay here if it's enough. If you can reach the foot, grab the right foot with the left hand. Walk your right hand forward. Or if it's still available to you, to grab the left knee, that's also an option. Chest open. let go. Sitting with your ankles together, feet flexed. Take your peace fingers, wrap them around your big toes. If you need to bend your knees to grab your toes, not a problem. Strong grip around the toes. With your slightly bent knees, position your lower belly on top of your upper thighs. So your belly and your thighs are touching. If that's the case, you can move towards straightening the legs first, keeping the belly and the thighs connected. Your heels may be coming off the floor. From here, pull on your big toes, opening the chest so you're pulling your chest bone, your sternum through the ribs to lengthen your lower back. Active stretching. Legs might be a bit shaking. Goal to get your big toes on top of your forehead one day. Simply round over. And if it's available to you here, you can clasp your hands and move them over your feet. To a cross-legged position on your mat. If you can sit in half lotus, if you have full lotus, you can do that. Or just a simple cross-legged position. Whatever's comfortable for you. Put your hands on top of your knees, close your eyes. Your jaw, let your shoulders hang down, relax your hips, hang. Let your skin hang down your bones. Like a shirt that's hanging. Easy. practice today. Bow your head down. Thank you very much for joining me. I will see you tomorrow morning.